So I gave an introduction to heat conduction, and we had a discussion on the coefficient of thermal conductivity K, and we derived this equation or understood this equation Q by T is equal to K A theta 1 minus theta 2 upon L. So after having this discussion, let's look at a composite slab. When we had this discussion, we had assumed a rod which is having thermal conductivity K, and the material is the same. But there are situations in which we may have a rod which has got conductivity K1, and there's another rod connected to that, for which the conductivity is K2, for example. And the point of discussion in this video is what would be the effective or the equivalent thermal conductivity of both these rods put together. So when we have a slab or rod which has got two different materials having two different thermal conductivities, we call it a composite slab or a composite rod. And objective of this video is to find out the equivalent thermal conductivity, which is going to be K. So we will denote that by a small k, K1 and K2. So let us assume that this has got cross-sectional area A, the length of this one is L1 and the length of this is L2. So this is a series connection. And we will analyze this and try to understand what is the equivalent thermal conductivity. There is also a possibility that the two rods are connected in parallel. For example, you may have a situation like this. This is rod 1 and probably this is the rod 2. So the cross-section areas in this case are A1, A2, thermal conductivity K1, K2, and the length of is L. And this is a parallel connection. Let us begin with this one. So we have these two rods K1 and K2, and we want to find out the equivalent thermal conductivity. Now, if we assume steady state conditions, the rate of heat transfer across all cross sections will be same. So Q by T, which is the rate of heat transfer, will be equal to Q1 by T. Q1 is the rate of heat transfer in the part 1, or let me call this 1 and 2, material 1 and material 2, Q1 by T. And that will be equal to Q2 by T. So the rate of heat transfer across the entire rod is same because it's in series, and we know rate of heat transfer across all section is same in case of a steady state. So use this equation for Q1 by T. Use this equation. Instead of K, we will have K1 and A and L1, and equate these two equations and do a little bit of math, and you will be able to arrive at the equivalent thermal conductivity. I'm not doing the entire mathematical calculation over here because both from an examination perspective and also from an understanding perspective, that may not be necessary. So I'll directly go to the equation that we get. The equivalent thermal conductivity for this composite rod turns out to be L1 plus L2, L1 by K1 plus L2 by K2. This would be the equation that you will get for equivalent thermal conductivity. So as you can see over here, this is how the equivalent thermal conductivity is related to the length of the rod and the conductivity of the two rods. Of course, we have made a big assumption over here that the cross-section area is same throughout. If the cross-section area is different, then the entire calculation becomes quite complex because there will be heat passing through the area which is exposed. So that would make it very complex. But here we are assuming same cross-section area throughout, but of different lengths and different thermal conductivity, and you would get this equation. I would want you to do this calculation, to try this math and see if you're able to arrive at this. Use this particular equation over here for Q1 by T, Q2 by T, and you should be able to arrive at this. Of course, you will have to use this temperature as theta 1, this temperature as theta 2, and you will have to also get an equation for temperature theta, which is the temperature of this particular joint. So theta 1 and theta for Q1, theta and theta 2 for Q2, and see if you're able to get this. Also, if you want to simplify this further, if you assume that L1 equal to L2, to make it just simpler, if both the lengths are equal, then L1 and L2 will get replaced by L, this also will get replaced by L, and then K will become equal to 2 K1 K2 by K1 plus K2. That is if this is the equation. But I would want you to focus on this equation because that takes into care everything. The main assumptions for these equations are cross-section area constant and steady state achieved. Okay. Similar thing can be done over here. Now in this case, here we had these three equal. What will happen in this case? So let us say the total rate of heat transfer for this composite rad is Q by 2. Now, this has got thermal conductivity K1, this has got K2. So Q1 and Q2, that would be different, because this will allow the heat to pass at a certain rate, and this will allow the heat to pass at a different rate, because the thermal conductivity is different. But the sum of these two would be equal to the total heat transfer. So the equation that I'll get is Q by T, which is total for this entire composite rod, will be equal to Q1 by T plus Q2 by T. This is Q1 and this is Q2. This is added over here. Here all of three, they are equal. Here these two get added up. Again, do the same thing and take temperatures, of course, theta 1 and theta 2, and you will be able to arrive at an equation K, which is equal to K1 A1 plus K2 A2 by A1 plus A2. This is for parallel. This is for parallel. This equation was for the series connection. So again, you can see over here, lengths we have taken same. So that gets eliminated from the equation. Cross-sectional areas are different. So this is how it is related to the individual thermal conductivities and the individual cross-section areas. Again, if we take A1 is equal to AT, this equation will become simple, and it will become K1 plus K2 by 2. So if these two rods have the same length and the same cross-sectional area, then the equivalent thermal conductivity is the average of these two. I just wanted to introduce you to the thermal conductivity or equivalent thermal conductivity for a composite slab, and after having discussed this particular equation. In the next video, we will be discussing a very interesting thing, and the point of discussion will be how are thermal resistance and electrical resistance connected to each other, or how are they related to each other, and what are the similarities between these two, thermal resistance and electrical resistance. Thank you.